Good morning, everyone, and many thanks for the invitation. My name is Kenia Malpartida. I'm a PhD student at the Centre for Bioinspired Technology at Imperial College London. I'm very happy to be presenting today about my PhD work, a lab on chip system to detect malaria. Just to briefly introduce myself, I'm a biomedical engineer by background. Then I moved to London to do a master in nanomaterials, and I'm currently in my final year of my PhD in molecular diagnostics under the supervision of Dr. Pantelis Georgiou and Dr. Jesus Rodriguez Manzano, also with the collaboration of Professor Jake Baum and Dr. Aubrey Cunnington. So malaria is one of the most threatening infectious diseases. It is a mosquito-borne disease caused by plasmodium pathogens, which are introduced into the host through the bite of the female Anopheles mosquitoes. Interestingly, there are six different plasmodium species that cause malaria in humans. And among them, plasmodium falciparum is the most dangerous and commonly found. There are current treatments against malaria based on artemisinin combined therapies, ACTs. However, their broad administration as first-line therapy is starting to be compromised by the emergence of artemisinin resistance. This means that infected people are not responding to the administered drugs. As it is shown here, the origin of this resistance is associated to the presence of some mutations in the DNA of the parasite. Therefore, in this particular case, if the parasite contains the mutation A in that gene, it will be resistant to the administered drug and the infected patient may not recover from malaria. So is it possible to know if the patient is infected with malaria, which species, and if it could be resistant? So the answer is yes, and we propose the following workflow. So starting from a blood sample from a finger prick, nucleic acids will be extracted, containing both host and parasitic nucleic acids. Then we will perform the diagnostic by means of nucleic acid amplification on our lab-on-chip device, and the results may indicate if the patient is infected or not, and which species, and if it could be resistant. The nucleic acid amplification method that we employ is called LAMP, loop-mediated isothermal amplification, which, in contrast to the well-known PCR, it is performed at a constant temperature of 63 degrees. Results could be obtained in less than an hour, actually within 20 or 15 minutes, and it's highly specific due to the higher number of primers that are used. So in more detail, LAMP commonly uses six primers, targeting eight different regions, and amplification occurs at this temperature thanks to the strand displacement activity of the BST polymerase and the formation of complex repetitive structures that can be seen in the bottom of the pictures, which are called dumbbell structures. So based on LAMP, we have developed a modified version which targets the detection of mutations, and therefore this can discriminate samples containing only one base pair change. This method has been applied for the detection of drug-resistant parasites causing malaria, and as we can see in the diagram below, we will have three reaction webs containing the same input sample. A reaction targeting a human gene to verify successful nucleic acid extraction, which is the control well, and always should be positive. A reaction targeting the wild-type allele, meaning the detection of the presence of the parasite that will be affected by the drug, and a reaction targeting the mutant allele, which aims to detect the presence of the parasite that could be resistant to the drug. So So taking a sample from a subject, a blood from a finger prick, we may encounter three different scenarios. And A is that the subject is healthy. So both wild type and mutant reactions are negative. The other is that the subject is infected but will respond to the treatment. In this case, only the wild type reaction is positive. And at the right, you can see a standard with the examples as DNA copies per reaction down to 50 copies under 30 minutes. And the third scenario is that the subject is infected but with resistant parasites and therefore will not respond to the treatment. And this, in this case, only the mutant reaction will be showing a signal. So therefore, the proposed LAMP assay targeting drug resistance is capable of diagnosing patients who may be infected with the drug resistance malaria under 30 minutes. On the other hand, we are working on a panel for the specific detection of the different Plasmodium species. We have been developing LAMP assays targeting six human infective species, and so far, all of them perform under 15 minutes with high sensitivity and specificity. As an example, we have published a couple of years ago a LAMP assay targeting Plasmodium falciparum, and we have demonstrated the capability of quantifying on our laboratory platform. So in the figures below, you can see three different concentrations, and the same reactions were performed in our lab on chip platform in a commercial instrument, and the results are very comparable. But what do I mean with lab on a chip platform? So I'm happy to introduce Leishwin, which is a lab on chip diagnostic platform developed in our group, which is portable and handheld. It is composed of a platform unit, which includes a temperature controller, a microfluidic cartridge, which is disposable, where the amplification reaction occurs, and an Android app to visualize the results in real time and geolocalize where the test is performed. The sensor area is based on microchip technology, composed of ion-sensitive field effect transistors, ISFETs sensors, that measure pH changes. So the idea is when DNA amplification occurs, protons are released, and therefore the pH of the solution decreases, and this change in pH is measured with our ISFET sensors, giving a sigmoidal signal, which is very similar to the one you can get from fluorescence in a conventional instrument, meaning that the pathogen is being detected. So we are working towards the integration of a sample-to-answer diagnostic device, and for that purpose, we are developing rapid, low-cost extraction from blood and the incorporation of lyophilized reagents to avoid cold chain. So just to summarize, we have developed a LAMP method for the detection of mutations related to artemisinin resistance, and LAMP assays for the rapid detection of Plasmodium species causing malaria in humans, a laboratory platform integrating LAMP for portable and cloud-connected diagnostics, and we are aiming to integrate a simple sample preparation module and dried reagents with our portable platform for point-of-care diagnostics. So I would like to acknowledge the Digital Diagnostics for Africa Network and the team at Imperial College London, and thank you very much all for listening. Happy to answer any questions.